Good morning, all of you. Welcome to the Telangana Model School YouTube webinar. We are conducting this online webinar since last 1 month or so. Many students are following the YouTube channel. They are viewing the channel both live and after the session also. So far, we had more than 16 lakh viewership. That is a very good sign. We are covering all the subjects, both Telugu, English, Maths, Physics, Chemistry, BPC subjects, Botany, Zoology, and for CEC. So for all the subjects we are covering so far, we are yet to cover only one subject, that is Telugu. Very soon that will also commence. So once again, I welcome you to the today's session. I welcome all the principals, teachers, and students who are viewing across the state. And we are having viewership beyond our state also, from our neighboring states such as Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka also. Some students are viewing this. And teachers from other institutes such as KV, Navodaya are also watching this channel and they are giving their feedback. So today I invite D. Venkatrama Rao Garu, PGT TSMS Jakkapalli, Narsapur sir. So today he will be dealing about the financial markets. So in this financial markets, he will discuss about the various types of markets, where people can invest and earn money, and where the business transactions will take place. Sir earlier discussed about the depreciation as part of the accountancy. So we had a good time at that particular point of time. Hope sir will further enrich our knowledge. Such a knowledge is not needed for not only the students of commerce. Every individual, as part of their financial management, have to have a grip on this particular subject. I welcome D. Venkatrama Rao Garu. Sir, please continue with your topic, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. A very good morning to all the respected principal ma'ams and sirs and my dear students. Today we are going to focus on commerce subject. Okay, we have got financial markets. You all are aware that in our intermediate second year level we have both commerce and accountancy. Earlier we were discussing about depreciation in accountancy. Now we will be focusing on our commerce subject, where we will be dealing with our financial markets. Okay, you already know who I am, and you had a good introduction from sir. Okay, these are the learning objectives as far as our financial markets topic is concerned. We will be discussing meaning and concept of financial markets. We will be discussing about the classification of financial markets and what is capital market, okay, primary market, secondary market, money market, distinction between money market and capital market, organized and unorganized money market instruments. A big list, right? These are the learning objectives which we have to fulfill once we are done with our sessions. Okay, so no issues, but this we will be covering in two sessions. Okay, financial markets. In the first session, we will be learning about what is business finance. We'll try to recapitulate what we have learned in first year. Okay, and then we'll start understanding what are financial markets, what is the role they play. Okay, and then we'll talk about the classification of financial markets. And in this session, we'll be focusing mainly on capital markets. Okay, this is how we are going to cover this. And I welcome you all again, and I want active participation. Okay, already I know you guys are very excited, but I want more and more active participation. I'll be asking you questions and you should be in a position to answer, and you have to respond nicely, understand things, and if you have any questions, let me know. Okay, so ultimately the topic goes, okay, as far as the topic goes, financial markets, we have to be thorough. And remember guys, this is going to be an important topic and you all have to understand, you all have to learn. Okay, why? Because this is going to be there in our future. How it is going to be there in our day-to-day life. If you are pursuing higher career also, like if I'm doing my MBA or masters in commerce, okay, anywhere you go, degree, if you go into commerce, anywhere you go, this topic will be there. And in general, if you are interested in investing in financial markets, okay, at a later stage you may get interested, or you may be interested right now also. So you need to understand these concepts. For that purpose, I'm pretty sure that you have to focus on this and you have to learn these concepts. Am I clear? Okay. So let's start with our business. All these things we have learned in our first year. Okay. And we will try to recapitulate and we will link it with our financial markets. We'll try to understand what the financial markets are based on what we have learned. Okay. So business, you all know, literally it means keeping oneself busy. Okay, we are not going into the meaning and all those things. Let's see. Here is the first question for you. I want to set up a cloth showroom or a business, cloth business. Okay, RR Brothers, it goes with my name, right? So I want to start this business organization. What do you think that you need to get this business established and started up? Okay. Quickly respond, and I want you all to participate. What all I require if I am setting up a cloth showroom? Simple question. Okay, type your answers, be interactive, and make sure you are participating. Okay. Okay. So you need a premises or building, right? What do you mean by that? We want a physical place. A shop, a showroom. Okay, so you need a premises or a building to set up your showroom. Okay, or to set up your cloth business. Okay, one point we have already got. Next, what are the other things you require? Yes, you require furniture. In the sense, we are talking about all the things, right? Like not only place where you will be sitting your tables and chairs, you have to place your clothes also. So you will be going for your fittings, like your racks and other things, right? So I need furniture. And most importantly, I'm going into what business? I'm going into cloth business, right? So I need to have clothes. I need to buy them so as to sell them. So I need clothes. Very clear. And most importantly, to help in my business, what do I need? I need staff. People, human resources to help me to carry out business. I alone cannot do it. Okay. So you all know it, right? What else? You need cash. For paying various things, you need cash. Okay. So we are all, I'm getting your answers. Very good. Keep on responding. Okay. Now, to get all the resources for my business. Okay. What do I need to get all my resources? Whatever the resources, some of the resources I mentioned, this may not be an exhaustive list, but what do I need to get all those things? Can anyone guess quickly? 10 seconds. You have to guess this. To get all the resources for my business, what do I need? Yeah, I think I got the answer. What is it? You need money. So we are clear about that, right? If I want to have a showroom, if I want to have the furniture, staff, and if I want to have some cash in my hand, I need money. Without money, you cannot even think of doing business. Okay? And why do you do business? You know you want to make profit, right? So I need money. So where do I get that money from? Okay? Before I go into that, let us see what this money is all about. Now I told you that I need money, okay, for what? For my business purpose. So whatever the provision of money that is there at the time it is wanted, we call it as finance. I'll simplify this for you. Let us say I'm owning a small shop, okay? So I'm doing business, let's say grocery shop. And suddenly I needed money because I didn't have in my pocket. Where do I go? Normally, in villages, towns and all, we have these specific people to approach. Where do I go? Type the answer. When I'm in need of money, where do I normally go? Don't say bank, okay? We know we will go to bank. But before that, which is the nearest one for us, like in villages and towns and all, we'll go to a person. What's his name? Okay, what do we call that person? A money lender, right? So we go to him, we say that I need money. For what? For my business purpose. Okay, so he gives you money. Whatever the money you need. And he won't give it free, right? What he will say? You have to pay. What do you have to pay? You have to pay some interest for it. Am I clear? So he is providing you finance. The money which you wanted, okay, for your business purpose, that you are borrowing from that money lender. And so what do we call that? We call it as finance. Okay. To widen it, to understand it in a more broader way, when we talk about finance, what does it include? It includes your funds and credit. Okay. Whatever funds and credit that is employed in your business, we call it as business finance or simply finance. Now, the next question that comes to my mind is, what is that funds? We have already studied about these things in our first year commerce and all, but still we need to understand this to proceed ahead. So when I'm talking about funds here, what is that I'm talking about? I'm talking about all the pooled money. Okay. Say, for example, you are pooling your money from your pocket. That means that whatever the money is you have at home or from friends and all those things. Okay. All those money. And for what purpose? You are pooling it for the purpose of business. That we call it as funds. Okay. Am I clear? And next, credit. Credit, we all know. Suppose I'm not in a position to pay the cash or money to a person and I need something, what do you will say? Say, for example, in cloth business, I need clothes, but I don't have money to buy. So I'll go to the supplier and I will say, can you please provide me the material on credit? So when we talk about business finance, we include both of these things, your own pooled money and also the credit. Okay, the credit which you are getting. So I'm talking about both owned money and borrowed money. Okay, this is how you have to understand your business finance. I know you are all aware about this, but it is very important for us to understand it here. Okay, so we are clear about what is that we all require, right? Now we'll go ahead. What does your business finance consist of? I already told you what is business finance. Okay, what is finance? The money which you require for your business purpose, and what does it employ in your business, both your assets and credit. So we are very clear about that. Okay, now what does your business finance consist of? So when we are talking about business finance, what it is all about? So we have got two things here. What is that? We have got long-term finance and the short-term finance. Do you remember that we have studied about all these things in your first year? Okay, different sources of business finance and all. So in that one category we talked about is long-term finance and short-term finance, right? Okay, so every business, as earlier I was talking about a cloth business which you are ready or which you are planning to set up. So in that I mentioned we have to buy buildings, okay, we have to have a showroom, we have to have material and all those things. Okay, so what is that we need to have? We need to have money for that. For what? To buy your land, buildings. Okay, or if you are involved in, if you are into a manufacturing process, you have to have plant and machinery, all these things, right? Okay, so and you already know what does these constitute as far as your business is concerned. Land, buildings, plant and machinery, etc., they are known as your fixed capital. Okay, so to purchase my fixed assets, that means to acquire fixed capital, what do I require? I require long-term finance. Why is that I am insisting on long-term finance? First, we have to understand what your long-term finance is. Okay, so whatever the finance that you are acquiring to purchase your fixed assets, the terms will be for more than 5 years. Okay, here is a simple example which I am giving so that you will understand very easily. Say, for example, I want to purchase a building. Okay, so let's say in city outskirts it costs 1 crore rupees. Why do I need this building? I want to set up my showroom there, and imagine that it costs 1 crore rupees. So can you afford it just like that? No. Then what you will do? You will go for what? You will go for in search of people or institutions which are going to give you money, which we now started calling it as finance. So we'll be looking for finance. Okay, someone you found out. Okay, let's say you found a bank, and that bank is ready to give you finance. Okay, do you think that, let us say I'm borrowing 50 lakh rupees, 50 lakhs, okay, out of 1 crore, I pulled money from my pocket, 50 lakhs. So another 50 lakhs I'm going to borrow from that particular bank. Do you think that I will be able to repay back that 50 lakhs just like that? Or within 1 year, or 2 years, or 3 years? No. It will take a long time, okay, for me to repay back, because I have to start my business. My business has to get into a rotation, or it has to be on the wheels. It has to start rolling down, right? Then only I'll be able to generate money, okay, or profits. Now we can't say money and all. Now we are more matured with these terms, so we will be saying that we have to generate profits, and from that profit you will set aside some money, and you will start repaying your finances. So it will not happen in 1 day, 1 year. So it will be for more than a particular period of time. Let's say more than 5 years. Okay, that finance we call it as long-term finance. Am I clear? Next, and you can see in our picture, we have got images, we have got a building, we have got a van and computer and all those things, right? So all these, they are your long-term assets. Okay, so if you are getting confused, let's use this word. These are all fixed assets, which falls part of our fixed capital. So you require long-term finance to acquire your fixed capital. And this is a must. And we understood what is long-term finance. Okay. Now, it's not over. Once I have my business started rolling, okay, once I have my business started and it's working and it's going on, it doesn't mean that I bought my buildings, I bought the plant and machinery or whatever it is, and I'm happy. I cannot think that my business will be on wheels. So what do I need? I need monies to meet my day-to-day needs of business. Day-to-day needs of business means, say for example, somebody is, your staff is there who is working for your business, okay? So you have recruited that person to help you in your cloth business. So he won't come free, right? So you have to pay him wages. Or you are having an accountant in your organization, okay? You have to pay him salaries. And for that also, you need finance. And now I stopped using money, right? I started using finance. For that also, I need finance. The money which you need to meet your day-to-day business needs, okay? Whatever the expenses which you incur in your day-to-day business, it comes under the purview of what? Working capital. You're working, right? And these expenses you have to meet in your day-to-day life. And what do you need for that? Finance. What is that finance? It will be for short period of time. Okay? That means it will not extend beyond 1 year. Then we call that type of finance as short-term finance. Are we clear? Are we clear on this? In the beginning, we learned about what a business requires, okay? And then which started talking about what is finance. Okay, and now we understood what your business finance consists of and what do you call that finance which is required to have your fixed capital, and what is that finance which is required to have your working capital. So we are now clear, long-term finance and short-term finance. In simple terms, long-term finance, this finance extends beyond 5 years. Okay, short-term finance, it's normally less than 1 year. Clear, right? Yeah. Now, once that part is over, you all need to focus on this concept very much, and from now onwards our perspective will change. Okay, you need to understand this very well. You need to have a clear understanding of what we are going to talk now. Okay, so I said business finance we require, long term finance, short term. Now who provides this finance? Okay, it is the financial markets that facilitates this business finance. The next question that comes to my mind is, what are financial markets? Okay, so the markets in which your financial assets are created and transferred. Okay, what's a market? Anyone? Just simple meaning of a market. I'm not going into financial market yet. Okay, let's talk about market. What's a market? Anyone? Respond very quickly. We have to move on. What's a market? Simple market. Okay, you all are aware. What's a market? It's the place where you buy and sell goods, right? You buy and sell goods. So if you look at the picture, you are going there. Whatever the things that are there, you are buying them physically. That place is there. Okay, and you are going there. That seller is selling to you. You are buying it. Okay. So buying and selling takes place. We call it as simple meaning of it is market. But when it comes to financial market, it is not that market which we are talking about. That market in the sense, we are not talking about buying and selling of goods. We are talking about something which is related to our finances. What is that something? We are talking about financial assets. Okay? We are talking about financial assets that are bought and sold. Now the next question that comes to my mind is, what are these financial assets that we are saying are created and transferred in financial markets? Okay, so when we talk about financial assets, we have got shares, debentures and other bonds, all those things. Okay, where we can convert them ultimately into money or cash, and these are created over there, and there you need to understand this concept very clearly. And from now onward, when we move on, you should be in a position to clearly understand that financial market is something not an usual market. You won't find it physically like people going in. Okay, am I clear? Just step back and recollect the points which we talked about as far as financial markets are concerned. Okay, financial market is the place in the sense, it doesn't have a geographical place and all. Okay, how transactions are taking place in this market, how buying and selling is taking place on the market. Can anyone guess how buying and selling takes place in a financial market? Before I give the answer, please type it very quickly. So in financial markets, business takes place like financial market. Your assets, buying and selling takes place. How? In what mode? Online mode. Okay, it's online trading. Or you will pick up a phone and you will call and you will say, okay, this is how I'm going to sell my shares. Okay, so that also you can do, but physically you may not be able to find. Okay, step back and understand this. Market is your regular meaning, where you go buy, give money, buy and all those. But when we come and talk about financial markets, it will be like everything, where your financial assets are created and transferred. Okay. Suppose if you get a question, like if you are having a question in your mind, saying that earlier you talked about an example saying that you'll go to a money lender, okay, and you are borrowing money. Does the money lender come under financial markets? The answer would be, type your answer quickly. What would be the answer? Yes. Why? Because anyone who is dealing with finances or any institution which is dealing with finances, where these finances are created, that means your financial assets are created, transferred means they are transferred to other person. When you will transfer your financial assets to other person, when that person purchases it from you. Okay, am I clear? Say for example, I'm having shares in a company. Okay, let us say I'm having in Infosys 100 shares. What is that? When I'm in need of money, what I will do? I'll sell it, right? Somebody is buying it. So that shares will get transferred to that person when he gives me money. So all this comes under what perspective? Financial market perspective. You have to be very clear about this. Okay. So let us try to understand about the financial markets more in detail. Okay. So that we'll be able to appreciate what we are going to learn as we progress. So basically what these financial markets are doing is they are playing the role of intermediaries. Intermediaries as a link. Okay. So there are two person, like let us say you sometimes play as an intermediary between two friends, right? So that person says something and you felt bad or something like that, the other person. So he's not talking to this person, in between you go and link up. That is layman's language. We are not going into that. But now let us try to understand financial markets. Okay. What role they are playing? They are playing as the role of intermediaries. Okay. Now watch the image. Okay. We have got what? Savings, intermediary, and investment. Who is playing the role of intermediary? Okay, here in this image, who is playing the role of intermediary? Okay, so I gave you the question, now answer it. Who is playing the role of intermediary as far as this image on this slide goes? Okay, who is playing it? Okay, very good. I got the answer. It is the bank. Okay, fine. Now, what do you see on the left hand side? You see the savings, right? And what do you see on the right hand side? You see the investment. Very clear. Now let us try to understand what are the savings which we are talking about. Now you know your parents, they may be into business or they may be employed, salaried, okay? So they may be earning money. Okay? So after earning, they will be getting salary at the end of the month, or business people, they will be getting profits and all, okay? So you know that they get income, business people or employed. This is very clear, right? Now they will be spending their monies for their personal purposes. Am I clear? So in your home, like in your house, your dad earns, let's say. So what does he do? He brings the salary on the first of every month and he will say, here is the salary. So you will work out what are the expenses that you are going to incur. And let us imagine that you have met all the expenses required for that month. So you still have some money left with you from the salary amount. So what does your father do? He will say, let me save it. What does he do? He goes to a bank. He deposits into his account. Why is he saving that money? Because he is not sure what will be the future, what need may come in future. So what is he doing? He is trying to put that extra money into the banks. Okay, now when we talk about banks, you already know, right? If you have lots of money with you, what you will do? You will go for a deposit of fixed deposit. So savings, small amount, you are going to put it in savings account. You know different types of accounts and all. We will not be going into that, but for your understanding, what you will do, if it is small amount, you will put it in your savings account. If it is a big amount, what you will do, you will go for a fixed deposit. When you save fixed deposit, what is that you are doing? You are fixing the term of that deposit. So, and you already know, like you people may be knowing, you can fix, you can deposit your money as a fixed deposit. When we say a fixed deposit, it is the term we are talking about, time we are talking about. It can be from 7 days to 10 years. So I have 1 lakh rupee. So what is that I'm doing? I don't want to spend it now. I'm going to deposit in my bank as a fixed deposit. What will be the term? Let's say 1 year. So I'm assuming that in the next 1 year, I don't need that money and I'm depositing that money. Am I clear? And when we have studied about banks and their roles, okay, and their role, what would we study? Whatever the monies we are depositing into a bank, what we will do, what the bank people will do, that money bank people will give to those people who are in need of the money. In need of the money in the sense, they give them as loans. Normally, who are the people who take loans from banks? It is the business people. Unless and until you have a personal requirement or you want to buy something, you may not go to a bank to borrow that much, okay? But business people, definitely they go to a bank for a loan and all, if they require it, okay? So who is giving that loan or the finance? Bank is providing it. Does it come free? No. They have to pay for it. So who is playing an intermediary? And what these business people are going to do with that money? They are going to invest in their organization. They may be buying a plant and machinery. They may be buying a machine. They may be buying, a building. They may be buying anything which is required for their business purpose. For that reason, they have purchased it, right? They have borrowed from the bank. So where is the bank getting this money from? It is getting from the savings which are there in the bank. Okay. So, and now this business person has borrowed it, okay, and he has invested in business. Am I clear? So who is playing this role here? In this example, I was mentioning more of bank. Okay, in financial markets, not only banks, many other players will be there. Players in the sense, participants will be there in the financial market who will be playing the intermediary role. That means they are channelizing your savings, they are channelizing your investments into, they are channelizing your monies into various investments. Okay, why do we need this? If we want our country to develop, okay, we need this. We want our industry to develop, we need this. Okay, so financial market plays a very crucial role where they are channelizing your savings to investment. Am I clear? Okay. Before we proceed further, let us recap, like in a minute, what we have learned so far. Okay. We understood what is finance, business finance. Don't get, you must be very clear with what is business finance. So we have understood what is business finance, finances which you require, okay, for your fixed capital requirements, okay, and working capital requirements. Then we started talking about the financial markets and we said that they play an intermediary role. Intermediary role regarding what? Channelizing the savings or the monies, okay, into investments, which is required, which is very good for our country, okay, for our economy. Okay, now we are talking about classification of financial markets. In this session, we will be focusing only on the capital markets, okay? In the coming session, we will be talking about money markets. So when we talk about the financial markets, okay, this classification, sir, do we have other classifications? Yes, we do have, but as far as our intermediate level is concerned, we'll be focusing on these things only, okay? Classification of finance. And we have a regulatory body, SEBI, okay? And as far as money markets is concerned, is this RBI, which plays a very important role. This we need to understand. Now, what is the classification of financial markets? I say it is capital markets and the money market. Am I clear? Okay. capital markets are further classified into primary market and secondary market. We'll get into this, but let's go through this. The other one is money market. Okay, so money markets are further classified into organized money market and unorganized money market. Am I clear? Did you all get it? We already talked about financial markets, and financial markets can be further classified into two. What are they? Capital markets and money markets. So we are clear about this, right? And we should not worry, like we should not start thinking what is being sold in financial market, what do we buy and sell. That we have clearly understood. So we moved on. Okay, we know now what financial market deals with, what are the instruments and what. So now coming to capital markets, okay, what is your capital market deal with? So in financial markets, I have got two. One is the capital markets and the other one is money markets. Now I'm focusing on capital markets. Okay, so let us make things clear here. Financial markets, we further classify. What is that? Capital market. Why we have to classify this? To have a clear understanding of what's going on in our financial market. Okay, okay. Now let us see what is capital market. Capital market is the market where long-term finance is provided to business firms through sale of securities. Do you remember? In what does your business finance deal with? It deals with long-term finance and short-term finance. So now where do we get this long-term finance? We get that long-term finance in capital market, which is part of your financial market. And when we talk about long-term finance, what is that we are talking about? We are talking about sale of securities, right? Clear? Now the next question that comes to my mind is, okay, sir, you talked about capital markets. You said it deals with long-term finance and you said it deals with sale of securities. What does this sale of securities really mean? Okay, securities. Securities, it can be shares, bonds, and debentures. Am I clear? Securities, it can be shares, bonds, and debentures. Do you remember in your first year you have studied about share capital? Okay, do you remember that? That is what we are talking about now. Say, for example, a company is there. Okay, a company, for our understanding, let us imagine 10,000 rupees is the capital of the company. This is for our understanding. It will be in crores, okay? Crores. But for our understanding, I'm telling. So 10,000 rupees is the capital of our company. A company is there. Imagining or inviting people to be part of the company, to be the owners of the company, what it is doing. If it is asking only one person to give all the money, he may find it difficult. So what does he do? What is the company doing? It is dividing that capital into small units. Okay. So let us say 10,000 is divided into 100 units. So now each unit would be how much? 100 rupees. Okay. That 100 we call it as share. So if I want to be the owner of that company, what I have to do? I have to simply give 100 rupees and the company will give me a certificate saying, okay, Mr. RR is the shareholder of this company. How much money I gave? 100 rupees. Like that 100 people gave 100 rupees. So 10,000 rupees is the capital of that company, right? So now it has the capital. We are all, like including myself, we are all the owners of that company. Shareholders we call, right? Okay, so that is what we are talking about now. Securities. Bonds. Okay, bond is a agreement. We are giving money, company is agreeing for that, and what it is saying, we'll pay you so and so time, this much of money which you have given us along with interest. And we have got debentures. Debentures is similar to your shares, but the point is, share is owner's capital, whereas when we talk about debentures, it is borrowed capital. Step back and try to recollect the things what we have learned in our first year. So if the company, if it wants to have capital, okay, what it does, either it gets it from the owned money, that means in the form of shares, or borrowed money, that means in the form of bonds and debentures. more clearly, like let us say debentures. Now, whatever the debt, that means you know, right? Owing. So whatever the debt that company owes, that it gives an acknowledgement. Say for example, I give 100 rupees to that company, A company, okay, saying that here is the money which you asked for me, which you asked me. Okay, the company is giving an acknowledgement saying that okay, we borrowed 100 rupees from Amaro. That acknowledgement we call it as debenture. What is the difference between share and debenture? When it comes to shares, I am becoming the owner. Okay, but when it comes to debentures, I am the person who is giving loan. That is for our simple understanding. Am I clear? Okay, now step back and think what we have learned so far. Financial markets, they are classified into capital markets and type the answer. I won't tell it. Next session we'll be dealing with that. So in capital markets, again, we try to understand what capital markets are all about. So we understood that it is related to long-term finance, where long-term finances are provided. Okay, that means your sale of securities takes place, shares, bonds, and debentures. Now the next question that comes to my mind is, I didn't see any capital market, okay? Like student, you guys may be thinking, I didn't see capital market. No, you will be coming across this concept when you switch on your news or when you go through your newspapers and all, okay? We'll come to that again. So who participates in capital market? That means who are there who can really do anything in this market? Manufacturing industries, okay? Government, specific financial institutions, and individual savers. All these people will participate in capital markets. Okay, to make things clear, to make our understanding very clear, a company is there, it wants capital, so it is asking people to invest in their shares. Okay, so I am going and buying their shares. That means I am part of your individual savers. So I am part of your capital market. As an individual saver, I can buy shares, right? So that is how I will be part of my capital market. Okay, government can be part of the capital market. It can provide capital, it can buy, it can take over organizations. Okay, and we have got specific financial institutions like IFCI. In first year we have learned about this, right? Specific financial institutions like IFCI and all. And then manufacturing industries. So these manufacturing industries, they form into a company, so they are into production process, they require capital, and under their company name they will be asking for people to invest in their companies. They will be into manufacturing process. Okay, so that's how, say for example, Reddy Labs is there. It's into pharma, right? Making tablets and all. Or biotech is there. So they're into a process, production process. So biotech is the company, and they're into manufacturing process. How? Like they are producing tablets and all drugs, right? So they require capital to buy that machinery or that process, whatever is involved. So that capital, how they are getting it? They are getting it from capital markets. Okay, either individuals may have invested in those companies, or any other financial institutions, government, anyone may have invested in those companies. Okay, so we are clear about that, right? Okay, let's move on. What are the functions of capital market? First thing is, when we were learning about role as an intermediary, we have undergone, we know that like financial markets, they channelize the savings to investment. Okay, here what is happening in capital markets, wherever this money is in surplus, from that point to, they are supplying it to deficit area. What is that we are talking about is, say for example, as an individual, I'm having lots of money. Imagine I saved money, I have money. So when the company wants when the company wants capital, what it says is, come on, anyone who is interested in our company, please invest in our shares. So where this is happening, it is happening in the capital market. So I am investing that money in that shares. So company is getting that money, okay, or capital. What is it doing? It is getting involved into production process, or it is buying an asset. So, and its process is being continued. That means whatever the surplus amount that is there in the form of savings, that is going to the place where it is actually required. The company requires that money, right? So it is mobilizing financial resources. Where this is happening? It's happening in capital markets. Am I clear? Now I know that, like as an investor, I know that if I'm investing in a company or if I'm depositing in a bank, I'm getting interest, okay? I'm getting dividends, okay? So now I understood. So if I have more money, savings, I can deposit in a bank where I can get interest. That money, if I'm investing in a company shares, I'm getting dividend. Dividend is nothing but your profit divided till the end, based on the number of shares you have, okay? So I'm dividing, I'm getting dividend. So what will be my thinking now? Okay, if I save money and if I invest in a company share, I will get the dividend. That means I may add up to the income which I already have. If I'm depositing in a bank, I'm getting interest. So my money is getting accumulated. This is how I'm thinking. So what does it do? The capital market, it encourages savings. So I want to save more and more and then invest. Okay. So it encourages savings among people. Okay. And we talked about financial institutions, right? Like your banks, your IFCA, and other financial institutions which we have. Even LIC, GIC, all these we call them as institutions, financial institutions, okay? But more specifically, when we are talking about banks, what did we say? The banks, they have taken these monies, okay? And they ensure monies from where? From the savings, okay? Or deposits. And they are ensuring what? They are ensuring that this amount is available as capital for those people who require it, okay? For business purposes. Why are they trying to do that? Because if it is invested in business, that money, again, the business people, they will employ people, they'll give income, they will give salary to those people, and they will be spending, your production process will increase, the economy can develop, okay? So they're trying to channelize those amounts. And when more financial institutions are there, what is happening? Availability of capital will be more. So once there is availability of more capital, then what happens? More and more industries can come up. More and more businesses can be set up. Okay. So financial institutions, they are playing that major role of providing capital. Okay. More and more capital. And there will be a stability in the price of securities. Okay. Securities in the sense your shares, debentures, and bonds. So you have a clear information in capital market saying that a particular company share is so and so, okay? And we have number of players in that market. So many people are there who are having those shares and all. There will not be fluctuation in the share prices. There will be more of stability because information is available and you know what's happening in the capital market, which company is having a positive feedback, and which company is not having a positive feedback, okay? And how they are doing, all the information is available in capital market. So what happens? The capital market, it results in stability of your securities, okay? Prices of your securities. Speculation, which is a speculation. In simple terms, we'll talk about this, okay? Then I will link it with our capital market. What do you mean by speculation? Anyone, can you guess it? What is speculation? Simple meaning of it is, you are expecting something to happen or not to happen. That is speculation. Okay. Say for example, you are watching a cricket match and you are saying, okay, Kohli is there. He will hit a six now. He may hit that six, that ball as a sixer or not. That may happen or may not happen. But you are waiting for this to happen. Okay, for that to happen. That is what is called as speculation. Okay. Speculation results in ambiguity, confusion, lack of clarity. Okay. But as far as financial markets are concerned, its primary function is to reduce speculation. How? You have every information, all the information that is necessary, required for your shares and bonds and debentures, what is the price in the market, everything. Okay, once you have clear information, and also you have the information related to the performance of the companies. Once you have it, there is less chance for betting on it. Okay, that means your speculation is less, minimized. That means the share of the price will increase or decrease. You will not be doing that. If you do that, the prices will increase. So you will not be doing that. And it promotes economic development. I already told you, whatever the capital that is generated, it is invested into business purposes. That means for industries where they will be setting up, new companies and all. Okay, that is how they will be helpful in our economic development. So once the production process starts, again they will be employing people, they will be giving income and all. So that's how your economic development takes place. Now moving on. Classification of capital markets. Earlier we talked about classification of financial markets, capital markets and money market. Now we have the classification of capital markets. Capital markets are further divided into primary market and secondary markets. Okay. Primary market is known as the new issue market. That means a company is issuing shares, okay, afresh. Okay, that is like you are buying a car from a showroom. So that is what is called as a primary market. Or layman language, very layman language, you are buying a ticket from the counter as far as this, that particular movie is concerned. You are buying it from a counter. So this all comes under your new issue, right? So when the company is issuing new shares, it comes under the category of primary market. So if I want to buy shares from a company which is asking for people to invest in its share capital afresh, new, then I can just go and apply for it, buy the shares. So what is happening? I'm giving capital, money to the company, and company is giving me a certificate saying that, okay, Mr. RR is our shareholder. All this is happening in primary market. Okay, am I clear? Whereas when we talk about secondary market, it is the place where you buy and sell already existing securities. Already existing securities in the sense, I purchased a car from the showroom already and used it. Okay, now I don't want to use it further, I'm selling it. So I'll go to a second-hand market and I will sell it there. Okay, same is the case with your stock exchange. What happens, whatever the shares or securities which have been already issued in primary market, those shares and securities or whatever the securities that are there, that will be traded. And where they will be traded, they will be traded in a place called as stock exchange. So when we talk about secondary market, it is simply a stock exchange. Stock exchange is the place where you buy and sell your securities. Okay, clear? Okay. Original value of the share doesn't, or security does not change as far as stock exchange is concerned. For example, I'm purchasing a ticket from for watching a movie. Okay, 100 rupees balcony ticket from the counter, but I don't want to watch it, or I'm giving it to another person. Okay, that person is purchasing from me. It doesn't mean that he will have 150 rupees ticket to go and sit. He will be sitting in that balcony 100 rupees only. Okay, but the thing is, at what price he is purchasing it. Am I clear? Okay, we'll deal with stock exchange later on in later sessions. Okay, but right now we have to understand that are already issued shares and debentures will be traded in a stock exchange. Let's summarize the things, differences between primary market and secondary market. Okay, so we are very clear now. What is that? Issuing of new shares takes place in primary market and they are sold directly to an investor. Investor means I am investing money in that, as in, so their companies are directly selling to an investor and company is able to generate capital directly. Okay, when it comes to secondary market, what's happening? Buying and selling of shares are taking place which are already existing. Okay, that means it is facilitating an exchange. Somebody is selling it, somebody is buying it. Okay, that means there is an exchange of securities and it will be an indirect capital formation. Okay, it is not direct capital formation. Next.
Sir, good morning, sir.
We have buying of securities, okay, both buying and selling days. Next, we have got price of securities in primary market. You have got the prices of securities to be decided by the company. Okay, that means the company will say, okay, this one unit of share will be 100 rupees. Who is deciding it? Company is deciding it. If you are interested, you will buy it. That means I will apply for that share, I will buy it. Am I clear? But when it comes to secondary market, it is already there. Now, based on the demand and supply, if somebody is very much interested in to be part of the shareholder of that company, then he may buy it for more or less. Layman example, I already told you, balcony ticket, 100 rupees. Even though you buy it for 150 rupees, you will still have the value of 100 rupees only. Same is the case with shares here. Okay, even though you are buying it for 200 rupees, 100 rupees value of share, it still will be the same 100 rupees. But why you are buying it for a more price? Because there is a lot of demand for it in the market. Okay, where in a stock exchange you will buy it. And as far as geographical location is concerned, there is no specific geographical location as far as your primary market is concerned. Okay, am I clear? Secondary market, you have stock exchange. So methods of issuing stock, that means new shares, how the companies will do this. Directly, already I discussed this point a lot. Offers through prospectus. Prospectus, we know that newspapers and all, you will give, the company will give an advertisement saying that please come and invest in our shares. Okay, so they are offering it through a prospectus. If I am interested, I'll buy the shares of that company. That is one method of issuing shares. Okay, next we have got offer for sale. So the company will turn to a broker. Okay, the company will turn to a broker. Okay, and that broker, it will say that we want this capital to be raised. So the company will offer it for sale. And private placement. Okay, we learned about when we were studying about private company. Okay, in our first year, what is that? A private company cannot go to public asking them for capital. So what it does, it will ask or selected few individuals to invest in their company. That we call it as private placement. Am I clear? Rights issue. So when the company is going for new issue of shares, what does it do? It will ask the existing shareholders to invest in the company. Okay? Clear? Okay. And online trading also. These days what's happening? They are going for e-IPOs. So they are entering into stock exchanges, agreement with stock exchanges saying that why don't you trade our securities online. Okay, clear. So this is how we have proceeded in our session. In our session saying that we need to learn about the meaning and concept of financial markets. And then we started talking about classification of financial markets. Okay, we talked about what are capital markets, functions of capital market. Okay, so and we talked about classification of capital markets also, primary market, secondary market, and what are the differences. Hope you guys understood this concept and it's very important for us. It's at an intermediate level. If you have any questions, please let me know. Any questions?
Okay. Thank you, Ramarao sir.
Thank you, sir.
My thanks to Ramaru sir for giving the wonderful speech on financial markets, and I thanks to participants and viewers also for watching this session. I hope you all enjoy the session. I thanks to all of you. We have 2 minutes, then we will proceed for the next session.
Thank you.
Thank you.